Okay, let's talk about Time Magazine. It has just announced its Person of the Year for 2011, and the winner is... This is my drum roll for you. The protester.
Ha ha ha.
He said, even in the face of a cloud of tear gas or a hail of bullets, the protester prevailed by embodying the idea that individual action can bring collective colossal change. Let's find out more about this winner, how it was decided. Joining us is Bobby Ghosh, director, our deputy international editor for Time Magazine. A look in the program.
That's right.
I'm just relieved it wasn't Kim Kardashian.
She was right up there, I'm told.
Yeah. Is this the Arab Spring protester, or is this the protester in Lower Manhattan in Seattle? Which protester is this?
All of them.
I think.
Yeah, here you go. Thank you.
Formed our choice quite substantially, but a year that began with the Arab Spring is ending with protests still in some parts of the Arab world, like in Syria, or protests in Russia, protests in downtown New York.
Thank you.
Around the world. And so the Arab Spring protester inspired protests around the world. And so we decided in the end that rather than pick on any one individual or even any one small group, we would go for...
Have those latter protesters resulted in colossal change? Or is the Arab Spring the only one that is... colossal change?
Well, a lot of these protests are still in progress, so we could yet see colossal change. For instance, in Russia, there's mounting pressure on Vladimir Putin to make changes. And even where the changes have not been colossal, they've still been quite significant. Protesters have changed the way we think of some of the big issues of our time. They've changed the national, international discussion around the economy, around dictatorship, around whether stability is more important than the people's right to choose. They've forced us to think of the world in profoundly new ways, and for that reason, we decided that the protester had to be the person.
But what's interesting it's a person of the year and some huge name out there, but this is really a celebration of the common man.
Yes, it is, and it was the year in which, if you like, the common man did remarkably uncommon things. They rose up in the Middle East and in Europe and in places like India. They rose up from years of accepting the realities as they were, accepting the certainties as they were, and they changed it. So there are no certainties anymore in our world, and in a good way, because people won't take it anymore.
Thank you.
Was it a tough decision, or did you clearly, just knowing the news flow of the year, it was clear that this was a person, or people, I guess, this was their year, this was their time?
It's never an easy decision. There were plenty of other contenders.
Can you tell us who the other contenders
are? Who was that
before? Well, we have actually, for the past several years, we've not only announced the person of the year, but we have a series of runners-up. So Admiral McRaven, who's in charge of the special ops and who sort of led, if you like, the hunt for bin Laden, which is one of them, the Chinese painter Ai Weiwei, who was arrested this year for standing up to the Chinese authorities, Paul Ryan of the Republican Party, and the lady called Kate Middleton. I don't know anything about
Kate Middleton. Kate Middleton.
Well,
at least it wasn't HIPAA.
It was she's become a style icon, and millions of people around the world look to her for how they should.
She's the freaking person of the year, please.
Okay.
Kate Middleton, the freaking person of the year. That's Rochelle's niece.
She didn't win, and Kim Kardashian didn't win. You had an online poll where you asked readers to register a vote. Who they think the person of the year should be? And there were some surprisers, because coming in first place was Turkey's prime minister, and then second place was the 24-year-old Argentinian soccer player. Did that surprise you?
Well, not really, because the Time.com poll is an expression of popularity. And by the way, we take it seriously, and it informed our discussions. Prime Minister Erdogan of Turkey, remarkably, was the most popular and also the least popular. So he got the maximum number of votes for him to be person of the year, and the maximum number of votes against. And that tells you that he's a polarizing but very interesting figure. Lionel Messi, the soccer player that we talked about, is just the greatest player since Pelé, and some people would argue maybe greater. I certainly would think that. So,
I was just surprised that, being an American, as you are, I was just surprised that an American didn't come in first or second.
It's an international poll, and I think the American population being smaller than let's say the populations of China and India.
Oh, we are not. Stop. I want to just look at some past winners. 1995, Newt Gingrich. 1969, Middle Americans. Two people. Two groups, two persons of the year that are right back in the middle of the fray today. So.
Hey, people of America and all over the world. Good morning, Paul Mucker here. Hey, people, I have a joke for y'all, right? Do y'all remember that Newt Gingrich, whatever the hell his name is, when he said the occupiers, whilst the occupiers need to take showers, something like that? Okay. Remember what happened to Herman Cain, right? He talked trash about the occupiers. What happened to his ass now? Pigs are now wearing three-piece suits and walking on two legs. That's what happened to Herman Cain. What happened to Rick Perry? What happened to Michelle Bachman? No, Mr. Herman Cain, Mr. Newt Gingrich, you had enough to talk about people should go take showers. People, hear this joke about Newt Gingrich, right? This man, right, wrote a pledge of personal fidelity. This man, right, cheated on his wife, right? Right? This man been married twice, people. People hear the joke. This man went before God, right, when he married, and he pledged to God and his wife fidelity. When he married, he pledged fidelity to God and his wife, that he'd be faithful. But he cheated on his first wife. And then he cheated on his second wife. How many times he's been married? Like three times? Anyway. He cheated on his wife, okay, right? And he pledged fidelity to his wife and to God. So my point being, people of America, you Republicans, if this man pledged fidelity to God and his wife and he didn't keep his word, who the hell are you all for him to pledge a thing to? This man writes a piece of paper giving you a sign and say, oh, I pledge to be faithful to my wife and to the institution of marriage and family. What a crack of shit. What a joke. He did the same thing when he married his first wife. He did it again when he married his second wife. And he cheated on them. So, what is this piece of paper gonna do? If anybody really, really accept this thing, you are such freaking idiots. Who the hell are you? I'm gonna keep your word to you. It's a piece of paper. It's to get elected, it's politics. It don't mean nothing. And I can't believe grown men, grown people are actually saying this is a good thing. It's not a good thing, it's a ridiculous thing. Wow, Americans, y'all are beginning to give me second thoughts. Between y'all and the Arabs at least, they're not taking the nonsense no more. But Americans, I don't care if y'all hate me for it. These guys are feeding the flock for slaughter, and y'all are just eating it up like it's nothing. Feeding the flock for slaughter. Oh, I signed a pledge to be faithful to my wife and to honor the institution of marriage. Yes. Now can y'all vote for me? This guy is a clown. But you know something? That's what y'all get. Remember 2008, I told y'all that the Republican Party gonna go into oblivion? Okay? Look at my video. Wow. And it will tell y'all that the Republican Party is gonna disappear into total oblivion. Absolute oblivion. Because y'all are clowns. Okay, Bush destroyed this country. Even though I'm not a fan of Barack Obama, but Bush destroyed this country. The Republican Party destroyed the country. They relaxed regulations. Barack Obama had nothing to do with it. Barack Obama had nothing to do with relaxing regulations that collapsed the United States economy. He had nothing to do with it. And the Republicans are saying Barack Obama presidency is a failed presidency. Of course it's a failed presidency because you have made it fail. From the time Obama was elected, the Republican Party said, we're going to make it our duty to make Barack Obama a one-term president. So people, do you all wonder why the country is in the condition it is in today? Do you all really wonder why? It's not because of Obama. Do you know why I don't like Obama? Because he's not strong enough to stop and tell Republican what he think. Okay, that's why I'm angry at him, because he's not strong enough. He's not standing up to stop against the Republican. He's not standing up to stop against Evelyn Rothschild in England. Okay? And that's why I attack him so much. Not because I hate him. He's a war arbitration. Okay? Until you stand up and really, really show that you're the president, I'm gonna squeeze you. I'm gonna squeeze you, Obama. Because these guys are clowns. These freaking Republican guys are clowns. I'm a Republican. I'm a registered Republican. But these guys are clowns. That's why I hope Ron Paul, you're not gonna get the nomination. You need to split up the party. Split it up. Okay? I'm telling y'all right now, people, I don't see no election 2012, and that's my goal. My spiritual goal is to make sure that there's not an election in America in 2012. That's my goal. That's my desire. But if it doesn't work out, if my Lord say, no, let it be, I'd rather Obama be president than any of these Republicans. So Rand Paul, you might not win it this time, but set the, wow. Rand Paul, you gotta set the space, okay? Set the place. Because if you start a new party now, in 2016, we'll be ready. No, we'll be ready if this thing goes on, if my Lord allow this Babylon to go on for another few more years. I don't see it going on, but you know what I'm saying? Who knows? I don't know the Lord's mind. You know, he changes mind every time. But what I'm trying to say is that, Rand Paul, split the party now. Get out. Long term, Jeremy, long term, okay? Short term pain for long term gain. Get out now, split the party. 2016, we'll be ready for them. Okay? So, because these guys are clowns. These guys sitting there fighting for the rich people. And rather destroy the country. Rather that the country fall into chaos than allow a black man to be president for another four years. That's what it's all about. It has nothing to do with Barack Obama policies. He has to do with his race. And I know it. Who feels it knows it. I feel it, so I know it. Okay? And it's wrong. It is wrong. Because America is a rainbow country. So Rand Paul, here we go. Split it up. Split it up, Rand Paul. Get out of that party. Because all in the party are hypocrites and parasites. The Republican Party are full of hypocrites and parasites. And Rand Paul, I don't want you to be associated with hypocrites and parasites. Okay? So my friend, I love you much, man. Alright? It's like I know you from an ancient past. It's like I know you, Rand Paul. I feel your spirit. It's like I know you. So get out that party and split it. Because no matter what, they're not going to give it to you. Okay, so wait until Iowa. Wait until all this is over. Then split it. Get out of that hypocritical party. Because any party who will sit there and say they rather the country be destroyed than to let any man be president for two terms, it could be a black man, a white man, a purple man, but if you rather your country be destroyed just so you could regain the presidency, then I have no respect for you. In my fact, you should be dead. No, seriously, because you're the traitor. You are a traitor to your country, you should be dead. Anyone who would so sit back and allow the country to go to ruin should be dead. But I'm not no murderer. I'm not telling no one to kill you. I'm not even saying that. I say you should be dead. That's the truth. And you, and anyone who know me, I hate death. I mean, I wouldn't even kill a freaking mouse. That's how much I treasure life. I'll kill a mouse in anger, but if I see him, I'll let him go. But if I have time to think, I'll let him go. But if I don't have time to think, I'll kill him. A mouse. But I'm just trying to make an example that I'm not saying that I'm gonna do anything to you. I'm just saying, anyone who is so sit still and allow their country to go to ruin for no reason don't deserve to be living. I deserve to be in a prison cell. That's where they deserve to be. So Rand Paul, let's start a revolution, man. You're not going to start a revolution by being in the Republican Party. They don't respect you in that party, you know that. Okay? You're not going to get no say in that party. Split it. Okay? One love.